everyone, it's Justine, and welcome to the Pretty Pink Posh channel here. I'm excited to present this new video tutorial. I'm going to be using the Stacked Edges 2 die here, and I'm going to be using this arrow here, or it could be a part of a chevron. It's completely up to you what you want to call it. I'm working on some Nina Solar White 80-pound cardstock, and I'm just going to measure approximately where the end is if I were to die cut this, because I want to create three different colors and I just want to use one of my scrap pieces of paper here. So I've now marked how far I have to go with my ink blending with a pencil. You could always use three scrap sheets as well. So for my first color, I'm going in with some squeezed lemonade. I'm not doing anything complex here that requires multiple colors of blending. I'm just creating a background. So you could also do this, of course, with cardstock if you'd like. Then I'm going in with some worn lipstick for the second color in the middle. And then for my last color, I'm going in with some twisted citron. Now, because this is a die cut, don't worry too much if you get some harsh lines. Just be sure to clean off your mat every time you switch colors so you don't contaminate your colors with the other brush. So now that I have all three of my colors here, I'm just going to spray it with some water, and you'll see that the water reacts so nicely with Distress inks because it creates sort of a splattered look, and when it's dry it looks like this. So now I'm going to go ahead and add my die cut here. I'm going to secure it in place with some purple tape in order to get this die cut so it die cuts in the proper area, and I'm using my Gemini Junior die cutting machine, which means I'll have to flip it over in comparison to regular machines where you would have the die facing up and the cardstock underneath. So I'm going to run this through my machine three times so I can cut three of those arrows out. I've sped up the clock here on the video so that you don't have to watch me too much doing this, and I'm going to set my arrows off to the side here when I'm all finished. I absolutely love working with Pretty Pink Posh dies, which is why you see me working with them in most of the tutorials that I put here on the channel. I just think they're so fun and unique, and this one has really just endless possibilities with any of the three dies that it comes with. I'm now going to take some Tombow Mono liquid adhesive and adhere it down to my card panel. My card panel measures 4 by 5 1/4, and it's that same 80-pound Nina Solar White cardstock. I'm just going to go ahead and add all three of the colors. Since Twisted Citron and Squeezed Lemonade are kind of similar shades, I decided to break that up with the Worn Lipstick pink color. I absolutely love the way that that turned out. These are such nice light colors. I'm then going to go ahead and I'm going to trim off the excess pieces here so that it creates a nice seamless card front, and you'll see what that looks like now. So I absolutely love the way that it turned out, and it created such a beautiful focal point for my card. I'm going to be using the Hummingbird Thanks stamp, which is a very small stamp. It's one of those 4x3 stamps. I'm going to stamp three of those hummingbirds onto some white cardstock. Same cardstock all throughout the video. I am going to stamp with a Copic-friendly ink, Memento Black, and I'm going to stamp it a couple of times to get a really dark impression. I find that Memento Black, when you stamp it once, is sort of a darker gray color, but when you go ahead and stamp it twice, which I'm able to do because I'm using a mini misty stamping tool, then I find them just much more vibrant, much more detailed, and then of course that true black color. So when that's all finished, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to be Copic coloring. Now I'm going to stack a piece of paper next to it, and I'm going to test out some of my Copic markers, and this is how I test which ones to use. I want my hummingbirds to really match the background, so I settled on a few different colors here. I settled on Y11 for the color and then Y02 for the shadow. I'm only doing two colors. These are very small images and I don't think the shading is overwhelmingly important here. I want to keep all of the colors extremely light. And then for the greens, I'm going in with YG01 and YG23, and I'm coloring various areas of the birds. I'm coloring them all differently so that they have a little bit of a different shade. And then I'm going in with RV11 for the lightest color of the pink, and RV23 for the shadow. And you can see the wings, for example, I colored in all different colors, and the bodies are all different, one yellow, one green, one pink. and that's how I broke up the colors. So I'm adding my die cuts now to it. These are coordinating dies, so I don't even have to fussy cut these at all. I'm going to add all three on here and send them through my die cutting machine along with the white scallop die. This is the smallest one, and I'm going to send that through at the same time, because why not kill two birds with one stone, to cut that out of some white cardstock. This next one I'm also going to cut is the thank you die, and I'm going to cut that out of some pink glitter cardstock from Concord and Ninth. That is a very, very similar shade to the worn lipstick. It's slightly darker, but oh, you won't notice the difference when it's on there. So now I have everything completely cut out for my card, and I'm ready to start assembling. You can see how much I love die cuts here, because I use just so many of them on this card. I'm going to use some foam tape here on the hummingbirds so that I can pop them up on my card. So I'm just adding that to the back of those, but the rest of them I'm going to color with Tombow Mono Liquid Adhesive. I'm going to stick that frame here onto the front just to break up the color a little bit and add a little bit of a focal point for the sentiment. I'm going to go along with the same glue, and I'm going to add the thank you die. These are very, very beautiful script dies that are quite thin, so I prefer to use a liquid adhesive rather than a tape runner or something. And I'm going to stick that on there, and I'm not going to completely push it down until I have both of the words on there. And the reason being is then I can go ahead and adjust if needed. And how I like to push down on them so I don't get my fingers dirty is I grab an acrylic block and I stick it on top. They're usually pretty heavy, and that's going to adhere everything on there with no issues. Then I'm going to just simply add the hummingbirds around the card. You'll notice that my card focuses a lot on threes. So threes are appealing to the eye. I have the three arrows, I have three hummingbirds, and I have three different colors, and that's just going to make everything quite appealing. So now I've attached that to the card base that measures 4 1/4 by 5 1/2, and the card is all finished. I hope you enjoyed this card tutorial, and I hope I didn't go too quickly for you. I'll see you next month with another video. Thanks so much for watching, everyone. Don't forget to subscribe to the Pretty Pink Posh channel. And if you're interested in continuing watching some videos, we have some suggestions below. All right, everyone, I will see you again soon. Bye!